the deepest secrets of different bills. At Uncle Demi, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Went from the finish to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the matters, cause the real ones coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is your man, Uncle Demi, and I'm here today with another special banger for you. We're now sitting at volume 86, and today we have the Well-Rounded Wing. Yes, a build that a lot of y'all, again, have been asking for and demanding, and I'm very happy to give this build to you. Just typical, like any well-rounded wing or well-rounded build, it's just basically exactly what it is. It's a build that's literally going to be able to do anything and everything. You cannot really say there's one major weak area to this build. If I were to say anything, it would probably be the playmaking, but even then, it's still manageable. So let's actually hop right into it and let's get into it, right? So first and foremost, there's many ways you can make the well-rounded build, but I feel like if something's going to be well-rounded, you need to have some defense. So I chose the defense and shooting pie chart for this, right? And then for the actual physical profile, I went with the agility and I went with the strength just because, I'm sorry, the agility and the speed, because I just wanted to be a little bit more athletic. And plus, like I said, you're going to probably do more of the two position here. You don't have to really worry about paint mashing. So that's why I didn't go with the balance. I went here, but again, you can go between either or. It's your preference, all right? Then as far as your finishing, you want to max out everything at the top, right? And your standing dunk, you want to get that to a 62. That gets you right at 7. Then you want to max out your three-point, your mid-range, your free throw, and then you want to go just until you get to 4. So you want to get that to 49, right? Then you want to max out your pass accuracy and your ball handling. That'll give you 6. Then defensively, you want to max out everything else, right? And just leave the blocking and the offensive rebound open, and then get the rest there, right? This will give you 15 defensive, 6 playmaking, 14 shooting, and 7 finishing. So again, it's a well-rounded build, not too strong in one area, not too weak in an area, just a well-rounded, evenly distributed build, right? This build, obviously, you can play with this build on any type of level, competitively, whatnot, just because of the fact of he can shoot. Obviously, you will get your three-point shot to a 70, to a 81. You'll also be able to get your mid-range shot to an 83. If you hit 99.9, that's 84 and 82. So you'll be able to do that. You do have good finishing. Driving dunk can get to a 78. Your layup 74. Defensively, you're going to be good. You can get rebounds. You have a 90 rebound. You have an 81 steal, a 78 lateral quickness, 82 perimeter defense, a 76 interior defense. So you can do, like, again, you can do a little bit of everything. Now, your body type, you want to go solid. Go to 6'8", all right? Going to 6'8" just gets you a little bit bigger. You do get a hit on your physical attributes, but going 6'8" just makes you a little bit bigger. And again, just makes it a little bit easier because you're going against smaller guards. So it gives you an advantage there. All right, your weight, keep the same at 222. And then your wingspan, you want to keep that also at 84.8. All right, so as you can see, your attributes have not changed that much or changed to the point to where you need to feel like you're too weak in one area or whatnot. You see what I'm saying? And the cool thing is that you have 4 takeovers to pick from. Me personally, I think it either comes down to lockdown and spot up shooter, but obviously I just don't think that lockdown is something you really need. I think the spot up shooter, you can get more bang for your buck and you can help your team out more as playing as a cone, either in the corner or at the elbow, catching and shooting. So that's why I went with the spot up shooting takeover, right? And there you have it, the well-rounded wing. Now, what we're gonna do is just go ahead and test this build out. First is get this build to a 99 real quick, and then let's just talk about these badges. All right, so we go ahead and get him here. Bam. All right, so then now when it comes to your finishing badges, what you want to do is you want to get your contact finisher to gold, right? That's obvious. You want to get your contact finisher to gold, and then being at 6'8", you don't have to worry about Giant Slayer. I think you should get your consistent finisher as a badge that you want to get just because it helps with your layups, and then your relentless finisher, right? I think those two will go hand in hand. With seven badges, you don't have a lot to pick from, but there's other badges that you could probably want to get, maybe acrobat. Of course, fancy footwork's good. Pro touch is good also. If you want to catch lobs, lob city finisher, those are the ones I would say that would probably be the ones that I would love to have. But again, if you hit legend, which of course that's something I plan on doing, I always think about that. Yo, when I hit legend, I'll have 17 here. You see what I'm saying? Like, I think about that, right? That's something to keep in mind, right? Now, I'm here, of course, you want to get your quick draw on Hall of Fame. You definitely want to get your range extender on Hall of Fame. You want to get your catch and shoot on Hall of Fame. And then for me, I think that, you know, hot zone would be great, but I'm sorry, hot zone would be great. Obviously, you want to have your hot zones to start off with. Then maybe you want to go Deadeye, but hot zone is something you definitely want to try to look into. But until then, go ahead and get Deadeye. And then when you start to get your hot zones, take Deadeye off and get your hot zone hunter, okay? And then, of course, again, though, it's your build. You can do it any type of way you want to, but these are the ways that I would do it. But again, it's your build. Do it any way you like, all right? Playmaking. So for me, playmaking, I think that the first thing I want to go with is quick first step. Get that on gold, right? Quick first step is just another really, really good badge to have. It'll help you out a lot just as far as, you know, your opponents. And then the last one, I think that either you can go with Space Creator, which is good if you're trying to do some hop steps or that nature. Downhill, increasing your speed and transition, right, with the ball. That's another good one, right? Tight handles is another good one to have. Now, keep in mind, your dribbling is not that great, right? So, with that in mind, your post is not that great. Your dribbling is not that great. I think that you're going to do a lot of spot up and shooting, so why not go with bailout? I know that sounds like, what, bailout? But bailout's a really good badge. If you're a cone and you're constantly trying to catch and shoot and you get caught with the dude actually covering you quick, you can go ahead and pass out of it without any worries. And that's actually pretty comp, and that's pretty clutch. I see more and more individuals using this badge. Of course, Tysino uses it a lot, and he has it in Hall of Fame, and it's like, dang, it's crazy how like fast, accurate the bailout badge is too. So it's a really OP badge. It's definitely comp. But again, it's your build. You can do any type of way you want. Now, defensively, you have a lot of good badges. And so, like, first and foremost, I'm going to try to go gold with these because I just feel like, well, except for Intimidator, we'll get that on Hall of Fame, right? But if you're running the two, you definitely want to get Pickpocket and Pick Dodger. Again, I'm not really high on Pickpocket until I find something else. Go ahead and get your Rebound Chaser on Silver. Get your Rim Protector. Your Chase Down on... So just because you're going to have to get your Chase Down dunks. And then your Interceptor, right? There's some badges that I would love to have, but again, you're playing the two, so there's a strong possibility you might be caught and having to guard the on ball, the pick and roll, so Pick Dodge would be really good. If you want to even go here, you can. I would love to have Tireless Defender. I would love to get Pickpocket if I could, Rim Protector. Pogo Stick's another good one, but I just feel Intimidator is so important. Clamps is good too. I mean, even if I wanted to go drop it down here, right? And then maybe go here just to get the animation. That would be good too. You can still get snag blocks with bronze. It just activates the animations, all right? So you have many different ways that you can actually go about this. It's really just your call as far as what you feel is, you know, the best, right? But for me, again, this is the way I make it. If you have another way, by all means, make it. I'm just giving you my opinion, right? So here you have it. 15, 6, 14, and 7. The long-awaited, well-rounded wing is here. Hopefully, you enjoyed this video. And, of course, if you enjoyed this video, you know what you need to do, guys. Please go ahead and like up the video. Please make sure that you're subbing to the channel. Obviously, like, again, we're making a huge push for the end of this year. I might want to set myself low. I would love to try to hit 12, 13K by end of this year. So, hopefully, that's something attainable. I think 13K low-key is actually attainable. So, maybe a little over 13. So, let's just see if we can hit that. But other than that, hopefully you're enjoying the video. Hopefully you're enjoying the series of the rare builds, and along with the NBA series, and of course some other series that I am having. All right, so if you're enjoying these videos, please go ahead and like it up, guys, and please continue to sub. I know a lot of y'all are watching the videos and you're not subbing. So hopefully this is the day that you decide, you know what, man, I'm gonna go ahead and sub to this guy because I really like what he's doing, right? But other than that, I hope you please again make sure you like and sub to the video, and of course you see me really, really soon. And when I say really, really soon, you know what I mean, right? I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.
Try to bring me down. See me win. You ain't like me then. No, you ain't me now. All of them coppers tried to call me. I can see you now. Biggest fans, they won't credit me.